What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about configuring the PowerEdge R620 Dell Remote Access Controller port, which is actually located right here in the back. This is the port that we are configuring today. I have a VGA cable connected to a monitor. My mouse and keyboard are hooked up in the back. Both power supplies are hooked up, plugged into the surge protector. I'm going to plug in the Ethernet cable to the port that we are going to configure. And also make sure that you're plugging in a cable that's connected to your network and also that is able to assign an IP address to this machine. Okay, you want a dynamic IP address assigned to this machine automatically. And then once you're inside the controller interface, then you're able to configure a static IP address, okay? So let's go in the front. Power button is located right here next to the Dell logo. Let's power this guy on. Awesome. Beautiful. Right now it's configuring the memory. And once it boots up, you gotta pay attention. I gotta pay attention. Make sure I have to click on a keyboard command. All right, initializing the Dell Remote Access Controller. That is done. That's the RAID controller, which I'm going to configure pretty soon with you guys. I don't have any virtual drives as of yet. We will do that pretty soon. All right, initialization is completed. It's entering the Lifecycle controller right now. You see the loading bar right now loading up. Okay, so the Lifecycle controller, little pre-built OS, has already loaded up. Things to do. We need to get the latest firmware, which I am going to do a little later, but we need to configure the server for remote access using the Dell Remote Access Controller port. So we're gonna click on this guy right here. Awesome. And then from here, you want to go inside network. All right, so it's gonna take you here, and automatically it is enabled by default. All right, the NIC is enabled by default, which is good. We are going to scroll down a little bit where it says IPv4 settings. It's enabled. Enabled DHCP is actually disabled. So I'm actually going to enable it. And because I want it to get an IP address. I mean, don't get me wrong, you're able to disable it and then just provide your own IP address from here. That's up to you. If you have an available IP address within your, you know, your network, assign it, apply it, and you should be good to go. But I want to enable it for now. And I am going to go back. I'm going to click on finish. It's going to give me a nice little warning stating settings have changed. Do you want to save the changes? I'm going to hit yes on that. Once you save, it's going to give you a nice little success dialog box. Just click OK here. It's going to take you back here. So at the upper right corner, click on exit. Do you want to exit and reboot? I'm going to hit yes. All right, so the R620 rebooted. Again, we made changes to the Lifecycle controller. We configured the Dell Remote Access Controller port to DHCP. Once I rebooted, it stopped here. I don't have a boot, so I'm not going to press F1. F2 is for the system setup. F11 is for the BIOS boot manager. I am going to actually do a control alt delete command because I want to reboot and I need to get back inside the Lifecycle controller because I stepped out for a bit and I missed it. That's the reason why I got that retry or get inside the BIOS or get inside the system setup. All right, so I'm going to press F10. F10 to get inside the Lifecycle controller. Again, like I said, I stepped out and that's the reason why I got that stop within BIOS to press F1, F2, or F11. All right, so we are back inside the Lifecycle controller. We are going to click on configure server for remote access. Click on that guy, awesome. And come on, awesome. We are going to click on network. And we are going to go all the way to the bottom right here. Awesome. All right, so everything is set to enabled. So we need to locate this machine within my network. And to do that, we need to get inside my DNS server and see if this machine was given an IP address, and then we are able to log into the machine. Again, you don't need to do this step. If you have an IP address that's available within your pool, just basically click on disabled, assign the static IP address, the gateway, the subnet, save the settings, reboot, and then you should be good to go. But for me, I wanted to do a DHCP, so I'm actually gonna go inside my network, scan the network, and see what IP address this guy received, and we will continue configuring it.
All right, so we just finished plugging in our Ethernet cable into the Dell Remote Access Controller port. We need to find an IP address. So the way that I found my IP address is pretty simple. I have a DHCP server running within my infrastructure, and it picked it up. The IP address is 1.1.12, and that's pretty cool. Right. So what you're going to do is open up your favorite browser. I open up Chrome, type in that IP address, hit enter. You're going to get this. The connection is not private. It's OK. Click on advance. Click proceed to that particular IP address. Now, the default username and password for the Dell Remote Access Controller portal is typically, I think, root and Calvin. I know with the latest models of the PowerEdge servers within the Dell lineup, they have like a nice little like a thing you pull out, and it gives you the passcode for this portal. But the default one, it is root and Calvin. If you enter that information and you hit enter, it's going to verify the credentials, and it's going to want you to provide a new password. So provide a new password, confirm the new password, hit continue, and it takes you here. Now, rather than going directly to the server, and my hands are shaking a lot because, you know, I'm always nervous, we're going to do the rest of the configuration within the virtual console. We're going to click on launch, and when you click on launch within the Chrome environment, it's going to want you to download something. So Chrome is not really supported on this portal. So that means we have to use, Internet Explorer. So when you launch it within Internet Explorer, it looks like it loads up. It's going to want you to install something. So click on install, click yes for the user account control. You get this nice little dialog box. Just click on allow and click on run. It's going to start connecting to the virtual console server. And now you're inside the lifecycle controller of that machine. How awesome is that? It kind of sucks that it only works for Internet Explorer. I was having so many issues with Chrome. From here, we are going to click on configure server for remote access. Click on that. It takes you here. Then we want to go inside network, and within network, that's it. You're going to go all the way to the bottom, and you know, the DNS name is that crazy name that we saw within my DHCP server, right? And if you want, you are able to basically disable the DHCP, right? Disable it and assign a static IP address as well as a subnet, and that's it. And then you're good to go. Then once you do all that information, click on back and then click on finish. It's going to want you to save the changes that you made. Click yes, and then you go. Reboot your machine, and now you have a static IP address to log into your PowerEdge server. Unfortunately, this PowerEdge was actually the PowerEdge 620 that I purchased, and we kind of did the unboxing together. And I'm configuring everything little by little and pushing out all these videos for you guys. So hopefully you guys enjoy this stuff, because I'm going to be pushing out even more. I think on the next video, we will configure together the RAID, right? And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Don't forget about smashing that subscribe button. And also hit that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.